concentrate on hexagonal primitive unit cell. Hexagonal is not that much important. The unit cell is a hexagon in this. Okay? 2-3 points write down. Write down the atoms at the corner. The atoms at the corner is distributed among 6 unit cell. Distributed among 6 unit cell. And in this, 3 atoms are present inside the unit cell. Inside the unit cell. Okay?
So only the 12 columns, yeah.
What?
So the only you just said there is
drawing it. Atoms at the corners, we have atoms present at these corners. Since the unit cell is a hexagon, that's why it is distributed among 6 different unit cells. Okay, so three atoms present at the within the unit cell line. We'll discuss this again in the arrangement of atoms. You'll understand how these atoms are arranged. Okay, just to draw the structure now.
So are they on the
face?
Within the unit cell. So contribution is completely one for this. Within the unit cell. Okay, we'll see the arrangement of atoms, then you can understand this structure.
Is it around
the plane?
Are they like in the same plane? Or are they just arranged
triangle? No, it's like a triangle, you can say. In the plane? Triangle. It's like this. It is one atom here, here, and
in the
So those other two are on the edges of the.
This one.
No, sir. The triangle.
It's like edge like this.
So, but they're all inside. They're not touching the face, right? They're not touching any of the faces. Are they just randomly inside?
No. Randomly we cannot say. It is an arrangement. We'll see that an HCP arrangement, we call it as. We'll see that you must have heard ABC, ABC type, ABAB type. So when we discuss that, you'll understand how these three atoms are arranged. This just you draw the structure now. We'll see the arrangement of atoms and then you can correlate the structure with this. Okay? So just give me some time for that. Now the contribution of these atoms are, like you see how many hexagon you can draw with it. One hexagon is like this, you can draw. Right? And one hexagon is this. Okay, so in this plane you see, this atom is distributed around 1, 2 and 3 hexagon. Okay, similarly you can place 3 above this also, 1, 2 and 3. The distribution is among 6 hexagon, right? Among 6 unit cell. So what is the rank of this? Number of effective atoms, can you tell me?
5.
Q5.
1/6 all of them, and so 1/6, 1 plus 3 inside.
No, so sir, those three have a contribution of 1, right? So it should be 3.
No, I thought each of them have a contribution of 1. Mm-hmm. Inside those 3, the triangle wala, that each of them have a contribution of 1, right?
Yes.
So that's 3.
That is correct.
And it's 5.
That's 5.
No.
So you can draw 6 of them on each side.
Oh, I missed one thing. One face center also. Mm.
Then it should be 6.
6. Okay, face center also. We'll understand this structure. Okay, so 12 atoms at the corner, and the contribution is 1 by 6, okay? 2 at the face center, so 2 into 1 by 2, and 3 in the within the unit cell, 3 into 1, so it is 6, okay? Coordination number, write down 12, coordination number is 12. This atom is in touch with this atom, 6, and this 6 atom, okay? Coordination number, again, we'll discuss when we see the arrangement. Just to write down here, coordination number 12. We'll come to this structure again, how do we get hexagonal packing, okay? We'll discuss that.
So, that triangle is considered one unit?
No, this is not triangle. These three atoms present within the unit cell.
Okay, now you just said
12.
When you said 12, so if you take each atom inside, then it should be 12 plus 2.
No, it's not. It's give me some 5 minutes to give me, you understand this. I'm telling you 5 minutes to give me, I'll draw the structure, the arrangement will see, two types of arrangement is there, you'll understand this, how the coordination number is 6. From this, it is difficult to understand the coordination. Just you draw this, we'll see the packing fraction of this, and then we'll move on to the arrangement. Okay? So rank is 6, coordination number you write down 12. Packing fraction you find out. Packing fraction. Here the relation is A is equals to 2R. A is equals to 2R we have here. These two cornered atoms are in touch. A is equals to 2R. Packing fraction you find out.
That's all.
Yes. I'll discuss that. Arrangement we haven't done. We'll do that in arrangement. Just give me 5 minutes.
So we're talking simple hexagonal.
Simple what?
Simple hexagonal.
Simple hexagonal, we'll see how this hexagon forms when arrangement of atoms takes place.
Finding that packaging of the simple hexagon.
This one. For this one. See here, the effect rank is 6. So packing fraction is what? 6 into 4 by 3 pi r cube divided by the volume of this hexagon. Right? Now volume of this hexagon is what? If it is cube, it is A cube. For volume of this, what we can find out? The cross-sectional area, means area of this hexagon into the height. Right? So this height, suppose I am assuming H. Huh? Yes, try.
It's a regular hexagon.
Regular hexagon. All this edge length is T.
So there's a circle.
Yes. See, one relation we have here, I'll just give you one relation. The length of the body diagonal of FCC divided by root 3. This relation, we can also derive this by geometry, but that derivation is not required. Is equals to the height of the hexagon divided by 2. This relation you should memorize. Sometimes they'll give you this value, A of FCC. You can find out length of the body diagonal of FCC, and then you can find out H. So sometimes they ask you to find out the height of the hexagon also. Okay? So length of the body diagonal in FCC is what? Root 3A. Here A is equals to what we have? 2R for hexagon. So we can write root 3a FCC by root 3 is equals to h by 2. Just a second, let me check. Mistake again, it's not root 3, it's 3. That's what you won't get. This is right. Okay, so what is the height h? By root 3. So once you know the edge length in FCC unit cell, you can find out the height of the hexagonal unit cell. Okay? Now what is the relation of, because you see, what is the area of this hexagon? We have 6, what? Equilateral triangle. Okay? 6 equilateral triangle. So its area is what? 6 into root 3 by 4 a square. Right? this area into height is the volume, A into H, right? So A is in terms of A. If H you know in terms of A, you can substitute here, then you get volume, right? Volume of this is what? 6 into 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, so volume of the unit cell is what? 6 root 3 by 4 a square into h is what? 2 by root 3 a of fcc. See, this a of fcc and this a is different. All of you, see here. This a of fcc, we cannot substitute a is equal to 2 r here. Because it is the edge length of fcc unit cell. So what is the relation of A and R in FCC unit cell? Huh?
So
root 3A is equals to 4R.
Yeah.
Right? No, root 2A is equals to 4R. Phase diagram. FCC. Phase diagram. Root 2A is equals to 4R. Right? So this FCC is equals to what we can write? 4R by root 2. We cannot write it as 2R. But this A is what? This A is 2R. Did you understand this? This is the body diagonal of FCC. So this becomes the edge length of FCC. And edge length of FCC is what? 4R by root 2. So this A and this A is different. It's not same. Okay? So now you can find out volume in terms of R. Okay? And then the packing efficiency is what? Volume of the atom, of the volume occupied by the atoms, divided by the volume of the unit cell. Okay, so packing efficiency, next if I write down here, the packing fraction phi is equals to, there are 6 atoms, rank is 6 into 4 by 3 pi r cube divided by the volume of unit cell is this, which is 6 root 3 gets cancelled. 3 a square is 2 r square. And A of FCC is 4R by root 2. When you solve this, you will again get 0.74 times. Same as FCC. Did you understand this? Okay. Here the calculation is a bit typical because we don't know the formula of this hexagon directly, volume of this hexagon.
Isn't it B square root 3 by 2H?
What?
Okay. But how do you eliminate
H? H cooling the other root 2A FCC by root 3 from this relation. Okay? Done? So packing efficiency of both hexagon SCP and what we say FCC is same, that is 0.74. Okay? Next, write down density of cubic unit cell. ECC is nothing, just we have, you won't get any question in ECC. We have corners and any opposite face center. Okay, so we'll have ECC as a questions. Not important. Won't get any question. Just you should know the arrangement of atoms. Corners we will have atoms and any of the two opposite face centers. For example, any center is this. Okay, that is it. You won't get any question on this. Okay, next write down density. Can you find out the formula of density for unit cell or crystal lattice? Density is what? Mass by volume, right? And mass means mass of any atoms, right? Any atoms, Avogadro number, right? So how many atoms here we have? That is, suppose rank is Z, so Z is the atom we have, because for other different unit cell, the number of effective atoms is different, correct? Like for BCC it is 2, FCC 4, right? For HCP it is 6, right? So we need to find out the mass of the given number of atoms per unit cell. So density, it's very basic formula we have. Density D is equals to mass by volume, okay? Atomic mass, suppose of an atom is m, means it is the mass of any atoms, Okay? Mass of one atom is what? M by Na. If the rank is Z, what is the mass of this atom? M by Na into Z. This is what? This is the rank of the unit cell. Right? So density is what? D is equals to mass by volume. Mass is this. So M
Z
by Na into volume of the unit cell. If it is a cubic unit cell, M Z by Na into A cube, where A is the edge length of the unit cell. This is the formula of density.